It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. Expresso here on SABC3, and we're back with a very special culinary hotline bling.
Ting, ting, ting!
And we have to get to your questions. It's very important. In fact, Chef Clem, we've discussed all sorts of things, but another question has come up related to your amazing whipping. Because the thing is, any challenge, you whip it, brother, and you succeed.
We do.
So, Nicole Chalant, Facebook question that came through. Nicole says, my cream does not whip stiff. I've tried using different brands of fresh cream, even added loads of icing sugar, and it comes out, wait for it, pap. What am I doing wrong?
Okay, 100%. It is definitely the fact that the cream isn't cold enough, your bowl isn't cold enough, and that's stopping the cream from aerating. So we did that already. I mentioned that in the previous one. But now I've got another one.
Okay,
let me first go back to that coconut cream, okay?
So can I just say that you were whipping this coconut cream for the last 30 minutes?
No, man. Don't tell the people that. It wasn't 30 minutes. It did get a little warm. But yeah, so you can see, once it's nice and chilled, it whips up perfectly. That's just coconut.
Okay.
Under the bus.
Sorry, man. Your arm is bigger. Anyway, if you want to call us, please, 021-110-5552. We want to hear any.
I was waiting
for this. How do I answer? I'm so nervous. Here we go. Culinary Hotline Bling, Colin Clem speaking. How can I help you?
Hi.
Hi. What's your name?
Z.
Hello. Is it Zenith?
Yes, it's Zenith.
Hi, Zenith. Please pose your question to Chef Clem. He's excited.
I am.
Okay. So, usually when I make cheesecake and I let it sit overnight, the consistency is very nice after it comes out of the freezer. But then it starts melting and then the consistency becomes liquidy. So how do I keep it in that nice consistency?
Was it a baked cheesecake or was it a gelatine set cheesecake?
It's a no-bake cheesecake.
A no-bake cheesecake. Right. So your no-bake cheesecake, did you use like a gelatine or a jelly in there to set it?
No.
What did you use to set that cheesecake? I'm curious now.
So the ingredients are condensed milk, cream cheese, and fresh cream.
And fresh cream.
And then tennis biscuits is your layer.
Okay, so it should still hold together, but you still do need a bit of a binding agent with that because the cream, it's not going to give you that beautiful slice that you really want. It's still going to be quite soft, quite spreadable, which you don't want. So I would definitely recommend, we have that recipe on the website and on the Willy's Taste website. Look for a baked cheesecake or look for a fridge set cheesecake, which does use a bit of a setting agent, which can either be gelatine or even jelly, which works really well. Mm-hmm. It adds a little bit of flavor to it. But also, the fact that it went into the freezer, you should never have to set a cheesecake in the freezer unless it is like a frozen type of cake, which cheesecakes, you wouldn't ever do that like that. So I'll definitely go to our website, check out those recipes, get the recipes that we have on the website and use those. A cheesecake, you don't need to set in the freezer. Did I help you with that one? It's definitely just the recipe. It's not you. It's the recipe.
Okay.
We'll find one, and I'll chat to the social media guys, put one up there. Definitely try a nice, easy one. The no-bake one, they're delicious. They're amazing. It's super easy as well. I hope I helped you.
It does help me a lot. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Zenith. So glad you called me. I understand. I'm looking for more calls on 021-110-5552. I got another challenge for you.
All right.
And now that we go from cheesecakes, we go to something a little different now. Ryan Pramlal says this on Facebook. I want to know how to make butter instead of buying it from the store. I love this question because this is exciting. Isn't there a cool process?
It's so amazing. So actually, because I was going to whip more cream for the other question about whipping cream.
Yes.
Not coming together. So again, chill bowl, chill cream, and we're going to just work it. If you have an electric hand mixer, I'd say bring that guy out right now.
Okay.
So what happens when you overwhip cream, it starts to split.
Yeah, it does.
Right? Which is a bad thing if you're trying to use it for like an icing or for like a cupcake. But that's what you want to happen if you're making butter. So I think Nicole whipped this by hand, and it was about 7 minutes of whipping cream by hand. And then this is what happened. She got this, and there's no magic to it. Mm-hmm. You just literally whip this for about 7 minutes, and you get this. If you're using a hand mixer, it's about 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes. It's amazing. That's the fat that gets separated from the cream. And don't throw that the milky mixture away.
Is that the whey?
It's the whey.
Curds and whey.
Curds and whey. Freeze that and then add that to your protein shakes because there's extra protein in there. Where's Ryle? Ryle's busy having a smoothie now.
No way.
This is all it is. Isn't it?
Isn't
this amazing? It's butter.
But it's exciting to make, and it's something that you don't have to purchase now. You can actually make it yourself.
This Valentine's Day, imagine you serve your special person bread that you've made, the butter that you've made. Yes. Heidi?
Can you imagine the lines you can say? You know what? I think you're smoother than the butter I made, baby. I mean, then it's... Oh, sorry, my phone is ringing here.
Excuse me.
Sorry. Culinary Hotline Bling. Colin Clem speaking. How can I help you?
Hi, this is Matthew from Cape Town.
Hello, Matthew from Cape Town. Please pose your question to Chef Clem.
I want to know, how do you make jam?
Nice.
Jam.
Yes.
Gotcha. Okay. So the cool thing about jam, and especially in South Africa, we have the most amazing summer season, winter season, and we get so many amazing fruits coming through. But if you want to like lock in that goodness and you want to harness the goodness of like a strawberry season and have it all year long, jam. So it's very, very simple. And the less ingredients you use, actually better. Keep it natural. Remember, sugar is a preservative in itself. So what I would recommend is, I'm gonna use strawberries right now because they are so beautiful. Strawberries and a little bit of caster sugar, just enough to balance out that slight acidity that you have strawberries aren't 100% sweet. There's a little bit of a tang. Add your jam to your sugar to it. If you want to get deeper flavors, a little bit of vanilla extract in there. Ooh. Vanilla and strawberry as a jam, yes. Then even though we've added the sugar to make it sweet, a little touch of lemon juice just to bring out the flavor of the strawberries. Super simple, on a very low heat. Just pop it in a pot and let it start breaking down by itself. Don't mash it, don't even have to mash it. It macerates by itself, which is the word. It sounds very, very gruesome, but it's not.
Yeah.
It's very gentle, actually. The liquid's gonna start coming out of the strawberries because of the sugar, and it's gonna start breaking down all the cell walls in the strawberry, and you get it beautiful, chunky jam. Nice and low and slow.
Wow.
It's gonna become a jammy texture, pop into a jar, and you're good to go. That'll keep it'll keep for years.
What?
And because of that sugar in there, it's preserved already. So I keep it simple. The fruit and your sugar, a little bit of lemon zest, and that's it. Vanilla, if you're feeling fancy. It's so, so simple. It works the same with peaches, works with grapes, it works with nectarines. Confit.
You're a jam, you know that. You're a jam. Give me a second. Culinary Hotline Bling, Colin Clem speaking. How can I help you?
Good morning, Colin Clem. You're speaking to Sandra from Cape Town.
How's it? Thank you so much for calling me. I loved answering my phone because of you. What's your question to Chef Clem?
Hello, good morning, Chef Clem.
Hi.
I try to make mince balls, these like savory mince balls, and then coat it with mashed potato and deep fry it. When I tried it, it came out mushy like foam washed up on the sea shore. It was horrible. Everything fell apart. Did I make my mince too wet, or was the mash too soft? What did I do wrong, or what can I do to do it right next time?
She made a mince ball.
So you said it was mince,
and
right?
Then you coated it in mashed potatoes.
Yes, and I wanted to deep fry it.
Okay.
And then it fell apart.
Can we start off by saying, don't wash your mince?
Don't you rinse your mince?
Don't rinse the mince. Let's start this. Don't rinse the mince. Now you can continue.
I've put in a request for if we're going to get a special soundtrack coming out soon called Rinse Your Mince, featuring Zoe Brown. Zoe, you are an absolute gem. Rinse Your Mince,
yes.
Coming out 2021.
It's going to be good.
First thing. She loves it. I'm a good
boss.
It's amazing. Okay.
Yes.
So, true story. Don't rinse your mince because the moisture is actually our enemy with this one. So what you want to
do is...
She's still loving it. I love it. Okay. So you're going to season your mince really well. Remember, mince is like a steak. So season it generously with a bit of salt and the pepper and add some fresh herbs in there. Okay. And then you shape that into the ball. What I would recommend at that stage is you want to brown your mince balls already. Okay. You're going to brown those off. You're going to have your little meatballs done. Then for your potatoes, what you're going to do is you're going to try and keep you want to stop moisture from getting inside that potato. So pop it in a microwave. This is what actually works best. Prick your potato, pop it in the microwave, and cook it like you would like a normal jacket potato.
Yes.
Then peel the skins off afterwards and then mash it. Season it again, salt, pepper. Don't use butter at this stage. Don't do butter. Again, butter's got moisture. So then you've got this beautiful mash that you've got, like you've made now, a rough mash. It doesn't have to be smooth. In fact, the more you work it, the more gluten you're going to release on the potato. Keep it chunky. Chunky's your friend with this one. So you've mashed it, you smashed it, and then take a piece of cling wrap, spread that mash out, take a little ball that's just ready to be browned off, and then kind of cut out the sections, and you're using the cling wrap as your mold, shape that mash over your meatball.
Wow.
Then awesome. It goes into a little bit of flour, a little bit of egg, a little bit of breadcrumb. Let that sit there for 5 minutes, then deep fry it. So you've got all that extra coating on the outside. It's going to protect the potato. There's no moisture in the potato. It's not going to pop. It's going to hold beautifully. If you want to make sure that they 100% don't fail, bread it, let it sit in the fridge, and then fry it tomorrow or later on in the afternoon. It works every time.
Wow.
Don't
rinse
your mince.
Don't rinse the mince and have a ball. That's what he basically said. Thank you so much for your call. And that's unfortunately
thank
all we got
you.
Time for on the Culinary Hotline. Bling, thank you very much for all of your questions on Facebook. Remember, you can call us next time on 021-110-5552. And Chef Clem will answer everything you need on the Culinary Hotline. Bling.
Ting, ting, ting.